Hello and welcome to the final episode of the Intellect series. I am going to be building my horde base that I made the other day, but this time we're going to do it in the wasteland. We're going to see if it can hold against that. Now, I gathered up a bunch of materials. You'll notice it's like a full in-game day since the last episode. I just let my forges go and just sort of AFK'd and drove around gathering up all my stuff. I finally have the 10,000 forged steel I need. Now, can you make steel blocks in your inventory? How long do they take? Ooh, 2 minutes each? That's not gonna work. That's gonna take thousands of minutes. So we'll go for upgrading, which is fine. There's 1,000 blocks. Dart traps, electric fences, turrets of all kinds. I made some of these, which are surprisingly expensive. They take 50 forged iron. I mean, in this economy. I'm gonna move this all over to my gyrocopter. My gyrocopter is filled with ammunition currently, because I'm going to have to fill a bunch of turrets now as well, because we're basically doing an upgraded version of that last base, but this time we're going to do it in the wasteland. Speaking of which, where? I do actually live quite close to the wasteland, so just heading out like there and doing it will be fine. Now, I'm going to assume that it's not going to take me the full 2 days to build this base, so we might get another tier 6 done. Hopefully one I've never done before. Which I think there is only one that I've never done before. Now that I think about it, the new one, the Ostrich Hotel, which was only added as a tier 5 in Alpha 21.1, I think. Well, no, it existed in Alpha 20 and Alpha 19, but it wasn't a tier 5. Let's see if I got 10,000 concrete lying around. I do. Most of it's at the other base, actually, but I do still have it. Don't think I need... Oh, well, blade traps. I was going to say I don't need anything else, but blade traps are a definite possibility. Is that everything? Are we good to go? We'll have time to figure it out. Let's head over to the wasteland. I am going to skip over most of the building because it is just going to be pretty much exactly the same. I should get a shovel before I leave. It's pretty much going to be exactly the same as the other video where I built it with a few changes because I just want to do the base in the wasteland and see if it's any good in a much higher game stage. I did go into a test world and test one thing though, and that was if dart traps activate demolition zombies. It doesn't seem like they do, so we're good on that. Hopefully. It was not a very comprehensive test. Oh, and I'll need to make hatches. Yep. Always forget something. That's fine. A really big issue I will have actually, now that I think about it. Definitely gonna need a wiring tool, so I'll go grab one of those as well. Wiring tools. There's one. That should do. I don't have much more inventory space than that anyway. Oh, and I should clarify, the horde is... This isn't empty? What? That's weird. I should clarify that the horde is gonna be on day 50, because we're on horde night every 5 nights now. Which means this will be the same number of horde that the day 56 horde would have been. But I'm still not going to be particularly higher game stage 160 yet. But the wasteland is going to give me a huge game stage boost. It's going to make it like I'm 100 levels higher. So that'll be pretty fun. Right, I'm going to land this gyrocopter slightly outside the wasteland because we know how it is for taking off. Especially with this much health left. I'm going to place one of these writable storages here because I'm just carrying too much stuff. Right, let's step inside to the wasteland here. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the central thing this time, since I have a better idea of how the base works. So it's gonna be a 7x7 box to start with. Also, what's my game stage in this biome now? 354. That is not bad. It's a real test. Right, there's the first 7x7 box. Let me go ahead and turn this into steel. Okay, there's my 7x7 box, all fully steeled up. Next, we need to basically turn this into a slab, complete pure slab of steel. Which is going to take a lot of resources, as you would guess, but I forget how tall it is, so give me a second. It's an additional 6 blocks, now I remember. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna go straight, steel this up, and then wrap another layer around it, and I'm gonna turn that into steel, and then again and again until this is a pure block of steel. Now, this is extremely excessive, but do keep in mind that that was kind of the point of the wasteland version of this, was to be pretty much as good as it could be, which involves a block of probably a good couple of hundred blocks worth of steel. If you want a more resource effective one, go back and watch the original video if you haven't already seen it. I'm definitely going to need more steel than that, but it's in my gyrocopter, so I'm good. Let me just grab it all. I can apparently carry it all at once, so that works. All right. There's a big layer of steel. We're going to go around with another one, and it gets exponentially more expensive. There we go, and let's add in this final ridiculously excessive layer of steel. And remember, this is not a tutorial. I am not recommending you actually use this much materials. I'm just doing it for the fun of it. The actual tutorial definitely recommends you do more like steel on the outside and then forget about it from there. Okay, and let's reinforce this. I have a skill point, let's go for some pain tolerance. Right then, so there's the big steel cube and that is the entire horde base. Thanks for watching. No. Next, we want to start with our bridge, which starts from the middle here. If I remember correctly, it was 3, 4, 3, so 1, 2, 3. We do a bridge, not a bridge, a pillar, and then we do 4, then we do a pillar, and then we do 3, and then we do a pillar. Then I believe it was 7, and then a pillar, so 1, 2, is that all? Is that as far out as it goes? I can't remember, I think it is as far as it goes, and then you do another pillar. Everything's so green in this biome. There we go. Then we do 7s again until we reach the end point. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One more, do the here. And then we do, I think it's 3 lots of 7 for the next one, but let me chop down some trees. Last pillar here. Got another stack of blocks on me, I do. Gonna need to remove this car, and I don't have an impact driver on me. There we go. So this is the entire walkway, good to go. Let's turn that into steel as well. Okay, the entire walkway except for this side here should now be steel, which is the important part. That's the part that really needs to be steel. I'm considering though, someone had a suggestion of putting like plates, that's not the right page, where is it? Plates along this so that if demos do explode, there's like an extra layer of protection. But it doesn't take up any extra space or anything. Here we go. I think I need to leave that block open, but otherwise it should be fine. Let's steal this all up as well. Another skill point, another point in pain tolerance. There, that should be good. I've just remembered, by the way, I'm gonna have to gather the engines from the other base, because there's no way I'm going out and collecting another like 24 engines. I can't be bothered with that. Okay, there's my little emergency way up. Let me build this first room. Okay, I've modified it slightly this time so that I have 2 layers of scaffolding ladder, which just gives me more visibility. It doesn't make me particularly more prone to any kind of damage because these are still cop spit proof, so I'm good. But it gives me more areas to see and more areas to shoot out of. Let's see, have I got more steel in here? No. Any more in here? Ah, good. Let me grab my turrets so that I can start planning that out. So if I put the shotgun turrets on that, can I access them from inside? I can. And I don't think that is going to give the, what are they called, the spiders somewhere to path. So that could work. It doesn't look very nice, but it should work. Make those steel on the block underneath them breaking, and that's not very helpful. So we'll do the same over here. And this one's steel as well. While I'm at this, I'll actually plate this off a bit more securely. Don't want them getting ideas about other areas they can attack. There, that should encourage them correctly. Head up a level. I got those SMG turrets on me. I do. Floating, but I don't care. And then one here. Cool, SMG turrets are up and running. Let's see. This time around, I think I am just gonna do scaffolding ladders on all the straight parts. Like this. Just because why bother with the extra materials, really? I'll leave access because I still use... Oh, I've done this in the wrong place, hang on. As I was saying, I'll leave access to that because I still want to come out here and be able to wire the blade traps and stuff from inside. Quite a useful ability. Let's go for 2 tall. I'm going to make it mismatched this time, but... Because I want it to be slightly... Oh, that's not in the right place. Because I want it to be slightly different and because... It'll take less time. And I have less time this time. So it makes sense. And then for the corners, there isn't really a corner scaffolding piece, so it just makes sense to use blocks. Keep forgetting this one side over here. I'll give myself another layer of a floor here, because that helps me store things like generators and cargo in a very compact base. And then railings, I'll just do like a sky cage. I won't even give it like a proper ceiling. I'll just start something like this, and then just drag that all the way across the ceiling. Let me turn this all into concrete. I actually have like 4,000 steel left over, which is pretty helpful. Still have a couple of things I want to do for this base though, including the electric fences and the dart trap thingies. Of course I'll need to set up the electronics, but we're looking pretty good. Right, let me go home and get some of the extra resources I need then, including water. Right, so with all my steel, let's grab rings and where are my mechanical parts? They're around here somewhere. I think they got all sorted into a random container. Well, not a random container, but the wrong container. There we go. I need hypothetically 5 vault doors, which I might just do because I have the materials. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I need 2 steel hatches. Then I also need a wooden hatch because I'm going to place the steel one wrong, and then I need 10 forged iron. Let's see, anybody got 10 forged iron in them? Here we go. So I'll let that all craft up and I'll get back to you. Right, let me fly back over to my base. Oh, and I'll bring water and food. Tuna fish gravy toast and some red teak. Let's head out there. Oh, and I'll make a quick stop over at the other horde base to steal all of its generators. Or not its generators, sorry, its engines. There we go, engines stolen. Let's go to the other base. Right, let's head inside here and see what I can do with the doors and stuff. Perfect. There we go. That should work now. Let me put a hatch on the ceiling here as well. This one I don't need to think about as hard. And then vault doors, just in case any spider zombies get any funny ideas. But it does mean I can access each of them. More so that I can do this actually and look over and like wire up various things. Let's see, generator banks. Fill up the generators with this stuff. Oh, I left my gas behind. That's annoying. Just in the gyrocopter. Nowhere particularly worrisome, but still annoying. I can carry all my shotgun ammo. Nice. Right, well, I can start wiring up all the turrets at least, even if not all of them are fully... even if not all of them are fully thingied yet. Right, and that should be the base completely done then. Just need to get more ammo over here, and I need to wire up those fences. Oh no, the blade traps, of course. Give me one moment. Ah, there's that engine. Right, let's see, there's a bunch of various kinds of ammo. And that is a whole lot of concrete if I need it, but I think I actually need more 7.62, because I only have a few hundred. And this is going to be my last sword night, so there's no point in conserving ammo. So let me head over to the crafting base, see what else I can pick up. More bullets. You're not 7.62. Take all my shotgun shells over, why not? Why the hell not? We'll also need extra meds. Let's see, first aid kits. Again, fort bites, recog, vitamins. I honestly don't need much else. Take some spare first aid bandages, why not? Alright, let me throw all this in here. Let's go see what Trader Wrecked has. See if he has like the tier 5 ostrich hotel or whatever it's called. I don't know if I could do a tier 6 version in time. I've never done it before, but I can certainly take a look. And if I have to ditch it, I have to ditch it. He's losing his quests. Like, he just doesn't have any more than what he has here. Bill's factory. You know what just occurred to me? This world was generated in the last update, so how is it gonna have a new POI in it? Like, what are you talking about? Like, turn your brain on, Bill. What are you doing here? Fucking intellect play through my ass. See, is there anything good? I've done it all. Director, are you selling dynamite so I can go and abuse something? He has 10 sticks of dynamite. How much does that cost? 2700. Let me go get some stuff. Some monies. I still, believe it or not, even after smelting like a quarter of a million dukes, I still have some.
You're not bringing counterfeit money in here, are you?
There. Now give me your dynamite. Yeah. And anything else explosive? No. Well, he's got HE rockets, but I don't have a rocket launcher, and I don't think I have the means to make one right now. Any duct tape or glue? No. Boring. Since I can't really use these for anything, Wrecked, you have fun with those. Let that be a lesson to you, my old base. Run away. Yep. Pretty much good enough. Fantastic. Let's go do it to my old horde base. Shovel. 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 This underneath it, one, and then I shall place one like there, and I will now run away and hope for the best. It survived? Excuse me? Heh. What the fuck? I'm sorry. You are incorrect. There we go. I'm pleased. So the final game stage is 361, which is pretty respectable. Now let me load all the turrets. All right, here comes the horde knight. Let's start spamming consumables. I've got some food and water as well. Yucca juice and yeah, I got the tuna fish gravy toast. Let's have a few of these. Okay, so for this horde knight, the only thing I need to worry about is killing cops before they explode. Because if they explode, they might set off a demo, and I'm not particularly demo-proof, quotation marks, right? Like, if a demo explodes too many times on an important beam, this base falls apart. But I do have a backup plan, and that is my machine gun here. This will give me 6 stamina per shot, so I just need to run and gun for the rest of the night if it goes horribly wrong. We are beginning the horde night. Let's get started. I do not see anything yet. Also, this is game stage 364, by the way. What is happening over here? Seeing a lot of radiated Hawaiian tourists, which are pretty scary. They do a lot of block damage. They're not too bad overall. There's so many Hawaiians. There's so many radiated tourists, oh my god. Why is that block about to break? What the fuck? It's just cop spit. Jeez. Cops are absolutely vicious now. It's not even radiated cops. In fact, with how strong the cops are, I'm going to reinforce this to steel. I am nervous. There's so many! They're all tourists. This doesn't seem economically possible. Let me see here. Refill my shotgun turrets for sure. Got a skill point. No. Something's bugged. Oh, that block is gonna break. That is not good. How are they damaging that one, but not that one? Oh, we're getting like crash errors. Oh no. Oh no, 7 Days to Die, hold on. Hold on, 7 Days to Die, I believe in you. Just 4 more hours, it's fine. Whatever's happening right here. Well, I forgot they can shoot through that. Not the radiated bikers. There's so many radiated bikers now. I'm gonna have a look and see if my SMG turrets need reloaded here. Hang on, did I hear a demo? Yes, I did. Not now, game. I don't need crashes while I'm shooting at demos. They're not crashes, console logs. Fucking hell. What is that fucking saying? Particle system is trying to spawn a mesh with zero surface area. Object not set to init. What are you talking about? What are you trying to create right now? Is there a zombie that doesn't work when you spawn it? Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh my god. You're annoying me now, game. Okay, fuck off. Ah! Stop it! What are you trying to spawn right now? Oh my fucking god! Every time I do anything! Game, please stop. Whatever that is, stop it. Oh, for fuck's sake. Stop! 7 days to die, but I have to press escape every 3 seconds. Ugh. Right, the SMG turrets need reloaded. Desperately. Somebody kill the demos, please. Ah! Get them turrets. Wait. Where are the cops? Ah, stop it. Fuck. No, oh, for fuck's sake. I don't know if it's something in my base. Or if it's a zombie the game is trying to spawn, and every time it tries to spawn it, it can't find the zombie it's trying to spawn. I don't know what zombie is broken. I would like the game to stop trying to spawn it if it is that, though. Why is this crash even marked as red? It doesn't affect my game! You're just making me press escape every 30 seconds! This achieves nothing! How are these doing on health? Yeah, they're fine. Let me repair my M60. Piss off, please. Ugh, 20 FPS. I am straight up not having a good time right now. All the ammo I have left, really? Oh no. Okay, Magnum time. Oh, there's so few frames to go around. I just need to endure the next hour and a half of 10 FPS gameplay. At least the crashes have stopped. And there's doesn't seem to be many demos left either, so that's nice of them. Get away from my door. I sure hope there is no demos, because that was scary when the hatch temporarily disappeared there. I was not a fan of that. I think as long as there's no demos, we can use that vine. And I don't see any demos, so I think we should be good. I'll just focus on keeping this repaired for the turret to do the rest of the damage. I can't even react to this. Look at the frame rate. Oh, I can't do anything at this frame rate. I'm trying to jump up here and get to my turret so I can back it up. I just can't. One moment, please. We're more powerful anyway. Give me this. There we go. This is absolute fucking havoc. No, not the shovel. Ah, I can place that there. It's helpful. I do not like that I can look here and that hatch disappears. It's making me very nervous. Hey, it's daytime now, we just need to kill off the rest of them. Have I got any more ammo for this? I do. There's a screamer in this horde. We're gonna have to do this for even longer. We done here. We're mostly done here. See, I don't think you've done that right, friend. Not now, zombie. Really? All those ranks in pain tolerance and I still get stunned. Bugh. That looks like a demo popped here. I didn't hear that happen at all. Hmm. Weird. Whatever, I don't care. We survived though, Wasteland Horde Night. Even with everything it was trying to do to cheat to kill me, you know. Let's get a couple of perks here. So yeah, that is going to be the end of the Intellect series, and I'm glad because as you can see, my world is starting to fall apart already. And I was really getting bored of the game there because it's just so easy, the build, and I got all the progression done very, very quickly, and it was just grinding for ages there. But we'll be moving on to another series next. The poll I ran, you guys said you wanted to see Desert Ranger with the Wild West overhaul. Assuming I can get the overhaul working and stuff, I should be going ahead with that. If not, we'll just do normal Desert Ranger and hope I don't lose my mind. Thank you for reaching the end of this series. I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you to my channel members and patrons for making these videos possible. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next series.